asshole. I don't care. What I do care about is just to have a nice attitude. And a nice attitude.
Hey, Bethers, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Austin Betha and I'm really glad to have you here. Please do want to hit the subscribe button before you leave and also give this video a very big thumbs up at the end if you enjoyed watching it, okay? Guys, let me just tell you, since yesterday, there's been conversations flying left, right, center, some interesting ones, some TMI, we don't consign us, we don't supposed to tell us, some very funny conversations, and I'm just like, oh my god, these guys are here to give us nothing short of undiluted fun. In fact, let us take it back from the very beginning. Yesterday, I told you people that as this male housemate have gone into Biggie's house now, you know, go to Tay, they're gonna start to talk babe matter, the kind of babe when I like, the kind of babe when I don't like. As I talk, now so yapu, because these boys, this men, this fresh men, you know, they call God, I can't talk about girls. In fact, Pera told us that, I see this way, he doesn't care if the girl is tall or short, he doesn't care if the girl is light-skinned or dark-skinned, all he cares about is her attitude and her astitude, okay? If you don't understand, go find out for dictionary, he needs the girl to be astified, okay? Anyway, they talk about that matter finish. They come to the discourse, go they say, okay, what if in a situation where two guys call like one girl, what do we go do? See, they don't really, they get all these kind of conversations, and I cannot wait for the girls to come into the house later tonight. And let me just tell you, these boys have made plans. These boys all set trap for girls. They say they want to prank the ladies. And as I can carry that prank for head, he says, see all those girls, say when they come now, they'll come, they feel like, say once they enter the house, as they want shout, say that they cut off, they enter, they go tell them, shh. Let's say now Biggie say, may nobody talk. So the girls are going to obviously find it very uncomfortable because why can't I express myself? Why can't I say anything to anybody? Why is nobody saying anything to me? I truly cannot wait for them to carry out this their prank because they've been discussing it. They started the conversation when White Money was still busy. You know, when he now came back to meet them, they still gave him the whole breakdown of how the prank is going to go. So even if the girls come meet them one after the other, say they go still, they do shh. Till all the girls come in before they now tell them that it's a prank. I really cannot wait. I feel like it's going to be very exciting. And they're already starting to give us the content that we signed up for, with or without the ladies. So you can imagine when the ladies now come, let me say, drama go boku, ego boku. They also had a bit of a chat here and there about the past housemates. J-Paul said he'd been like Nengi that time. You know, they actually had a lot of conversations. Perrin also had a conversation with Emmanuel in their dressing room area. He was telling Emmanuel about his relationship with his dad, and the fact that, you know, for the past how many years, he don't know who his papa be. Say his papa leave them at the age of 4, you know, it was only until he turned 24 and moved to the US that he finally met his dad. You know, he kind of shared personal stuff, you know, personal information, how it felt not growing up with a dad and all of that stuff. Boma also made it known to us that he lost his sister and now he's the only child. Sammy also made it known to us that he's the first child, he has two other brothers, no sisters at all. Now, speaking about food, una go dey ask yourself, say, since yesterday they never chop, let me just tell you guys, White Money has been the chef. The guy actually made it known to us that he can cook. The guy said anything cookable, he go cook them. And as I said, they tell now like this, Baba don't already cook stew, okay? He don't already cook one pot of stew where they go chop. Whether they use and wait for the girls, I don't really know. But the cocoa be say, one pot of stew is ready. Also, in the kitchen, when Boma was mopping the kitchen and everything, I don't know where the kitchen is, so they don't really they mop them. Boma and White Money were having a conversation, and both of them were actually being grateful to God for bringing them into Biggie's house, you know, saying that they did not know anybody. White Money say, I seen they like, they say, you know, no personal, say nobody epamo, say now God then carry and come, and is very very grateful. Say I want to go borrow money from person, say I beg, will sponsor me at the enter Biggie house. But my whole question now is this: even the person sponsor White Money enter the house, will he tell us? Will he tell us? He's not going to tell us anything. So more leave that set. More patchy. And let me just tell you guys here, this White Money guy is a real hustler, okay? When you say person don't hustle for this life, now White Money is supposed to call. Because that guy don't do bad work. He was saying all of these things yesterday. Some people were like, don't start, don't they lie. But obviously, pictures have surfaced. In fact, there was one I saw, he was cutting one actor's hair. I'll put it on the screen for you guys to see as well. He said he don't do bad work. Now, he they sell shoes, you know, they import, they export shoes. He they sell lip balm. He not really call and pick lips, but instead of lip balm, So if you want to moisturize your lips, now what's the white money they say be that? He's saying he don't do bodyguard work. So who should work when this guy never do before? Because all this work might be smart thing. He not too also. And I'm super glad that finally the hustle is paying off. In fact, there was something that happened today. You guys know that before they wake up, the alarm goes on and all of that. But today being Sunday, there was no alarm. So obviously they were all worried, like, ah, why the alarm not really sound like that? But then they did not know that alarms don't sound on Sundays. It starts from Monday mornings, and the girls are going to be the ones to suffer. Now, when they woke up this morning, they were just gisting about the fact that, oh, they don't know waiting time, they talk anymore. You know, and everything, and white money was there just to them straight up. See, as you enter big years, your life is timeless. Okay, all these years waiting, they do timekeeper work, you blow. So if not to live a life without time to blow, then you choose that life. As in the thing cracked me up this morning, I'm like, oh my god, this guy is a cruise. Better cruise than our white money be.
All the time when you know time, you blow. All the time when you know time, when you know time, can thank you back, correct thank you back. Did you make it?
Now, let me also tell you guys that the guys were sitting at the dining area and they were just gisting about cameras in Biggie's house. And Perez said, as far as it's concerned, say no camera, they Biggie house. I hear you. Do the one where you say we're not going to see. We're going to shock you because the theme for this year alone is shine your eye. So our eye, like you say, it be like if man touch, our eye sharp. So if you say camera not there, now you sabi. They come go see, they discuss again, say, okay, how are we now going to have our bath with boxers on? It's going to be so uncomfortable. You know, you're supposed to, you know, come on everything, wash everywhere. So, okay, man, I come out. Did they begin to show us bedroom shots? Or maybe we can see for show marks. Now, not matter. Because all the other male housemates that they use boxers bath. If your boxers too tight, cut the rope. If the elastic too tight, you know, use your teeth, cut down. You want to come on everything. Now, you know. I'm here for all of that. So if you see now the content, so you want shows, be that, I did, yeah. I go see her. Cause my eye is not closed. I go see her. Okay? Now, before I end this video, yeah, there's also a part where Yerins was asking Nii about his wife and, you know, how they met and all of that. Let me just tell you guys something, yeah. Our doctor, our housefly specialist, let me tell you, that guy is deep, okay? He's deep on a deeper level, all right? Because the kind of questions when they ask, the kind of conversations when they have with other housemates, is beginning to make me feel like, there's actually more to this guy. You know how they say, do not judge a book by its cover. No, because I don't already judge the guy, because all the things when I talk yesterday, now the things when in talk. The housefly matter when I mentioned yesterday, he actually mentioned that to Ebuka on stage. Okay, so it wasn't like I was just trying to bring up the name Mr. Housefly or anything like that. He was the one that was telling us that housefly till they use back the waka. Okay, so listening to him have conversations with the rest of the housemates, it just made me feel like, okay, I actually need to pay more attention to this earrings guy. Okay, and when he was talking to Nii and asking him about his relationship, Nii now opened up to us and said that he had dated his wife for 4 years before they finally got married. You know, he gisted us how he met the babe inside a store where he used to go and buy his facials. So you will be boy, will be man when they use facials when the attendants be women. Now your matter, because this guy now inside the shop when go shop for facials, now he can face in wife. Oh, better don't leave me. Anyways, that's all the gist I have for you in today's video. Make it a date with me today by 7 p.m. on my Instagram live. I'm actually going to go live by 7 p.m. on my Instagram page so that people who do not have access to watch the show can at least watch the live show and watch how the beautiful ladies will be welcomed into Biggie's house by Ebuka. You know, get to meet them firsthand. Not be say I'll just come back on the gist now and I will still see them by myself. So make sure to follow me on Instagram. It's at Austin Better. By now the name is already on the screen, so please follow me. Thank you guys so much for all the love yesterday on my Instagram live. I mean, just one day, and I love the engagement. I love the fact that we were having a conversation in the comments. It was really fun, and I really cannot wait for that. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching, and after the live show I will definitely see you guys on here on the channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys so much, and I will see you all on the next one. Okay, bye guys.